In this video, we'll go into more detail to describe our calculations of the standard free energy change for a reaction. Again, remember when we describe standard free energy change, this is where we're using this superscripted zero called the not symbol. Again, spelling that out so you understand what I'm saying. Not. Delta G naught is the free energy change for a reaction when that reaction occurs under standard state conditions. Again, another reminder that the requirements for standard state is that every solid, liquid, and gas is in its pure form. If we have solutions, they are at concentrations of 1 molar. If we have gases, they are at a pressure of 1 atmosphere. And the key condition that we focus on this semester is that we are measuring at 25 degrees Celsius. Translated into Kelvin, that's 298 or the optional 0.15 added on there. Key things to remember as we go through and calculate free energy values. Again, delta G without the not symbol is the non-standard value. This is the value that predicts spontaneity. And it's similar in concept to our calculation of the value of Q. Remember that we use Q to determine whether a reaction is going forward to reach equilibrium or whether the reaction is going in the reverse direction. So delta G, the non-standard, is telling us the direction a reaction is going. Delta G naught is our standard free energy value. And this one determines whether a reaction is product or reactant favored at equilibrium. This relates to our equilibrium constant of K. And so again, delta G naught relates to equilibrium. And one more note that I want to add in here. Pardon me for 1 second. I'm going to make a quick change to add in a new slide because I want to clarify the signs. So again, for non-standard free energy, when that's less than zero, we say that our reaction is spontaneous. In other words, it's still moving forward or to the right to reach equilibrium. When delta G is greater than zero, this tells us our reaction is non-spontaneous. In other words, it is moving in the reverse direction to reach equilibrium. When we calculate that delta G naught is negative, this is the same as saying our reaction overall is spontaneous. In other words, once it reaches equilibrium, we have produced more products than reactants. And so we call this a product-favored reaction. And again, we can relate this to our quantity for the equilibrium constant, where we would say that this is a value greater than 1. Again, any product-favored system has a large K value. Therefore, if we calculate that delta G naught, the standard value, is positive, this tells us that once our system has reached equilibrium, we have a reactant-favored system. And again, because that relates to equilibrium, we can relate it back to a K value where we would say our K is less than 1 or we have a small value. And in fact, the more negative a delta G value is, the larger the equilibrium constant would be. The more positive a delta G naught value is, the smaller our K value would be. For this slide, we'll go through a practice calculation of standard free energy. And so hopefully you recognize this equation. It is the same equation that we've used to calculate our standard enthalpy of reaction that was on slide 10. And we use this same equation to calculate our standard entropy of reaction on slide number 24. So we are going to combine these together to calculate our free energy of reaction. When we write out our equation of delta G naught equal to the standard enthalpy minus temperature times standard entropy, you might be asking yourself why I didn't give temperature. But realize I'm specifically asking for standard delta G, delta G naught. The assumption and the implication is that because I'm asking for standard, I know my temperature is 25 degrees Celsius. When we convert that into Kelvin, we get our 298 with the optional 0.15. Again, for all calculations, show me which version of Kelvin you're using, and I will grade your answer accordingly. For our sample calculation, we have our enthalpy value, -1,323.1 kilojoules, minus the product of our temperature. So 298, I'm using the optional 0.15 Kelvin, times our entropy, again, paying attention to the units here, converting that into kilojoules. We get -0.0297, and again, that is kilojoules per Kelvin. So again, we see our Kelvins cancel. That leaves us with the same units to combine together for subtraction. When we carry this calculation out, pay attention to your order of operations. Make sure you put the parentheses around your temperature times entropy. Again, for this equation, for the Gibbs free energy equation we're using here, whether in standard or non-standard format, the recommendation I always give for sig figs is to look at your original decimal places in the given enthalpy and entropy and report your final answer to the same or to the least number of decimal places. Since both enthalpy and entropy go to one decimal place, my answer goes to one. And so our value for delta G naught is -1,314.2 kilojoules. We have one more equation to introduce here that specifically describes standard free energy. And again, hopefully this equation looks familiar. So we are calculating the standard free energy for a reaction by adding up the moles of a given substance, again using coefficients, by the free energy of formation. We add up all of the values of our products and subtract from that all the values of our reactants. This is the same exact equation we used for our enthalpy of reaction and our entropy of reaction. So all three of these equations use the same format. We just plug in different quantities. The Gibbs free energy of formation, that subscript of F, is identical in definition to our enthalpy of formation. It is the formation, the free energy that is exchanged when we make one mole of a compound from its elements in their standard states. And again, just like enthalpy values, the free energy of formation for any element is always going to be zero. It takes no energy to make that substance, and so there's no free energy required either. These values of free energy of formation are also obtained from Appendix G. So we're going to do one more calculation here to compare our calculation of the free energy, standard free energy of reaction for our favorite combustion reaction. So notice here I've given free energy of formation values. Hopefully you notice that one is missing. That one would be oxygen. Again, recognize oxygen is in its elemental form, so I don't have to give you that one because we know that it would be a zero. To calculate my free energy of formation, I'm going to use the same type of setup that I've done in our other two examples. Again, we're doing products minus reactants. I'm going to put my products in brackets. So I have 2 moles of CO2 with a value of 394.36 kilojoules per mole. I'm going to add to that my 2 moles of H2O gas. Again, for free energy of formation values, make sure you're paying attention to physical states if you have to look these up. There's our products. I'm going to subtract from that my reactants. So 1 mole of the C2H4 times its value of a 68.4. And again, just like our enthalpy of reaction values, free energy of formation values tend to be negative because they're combination reactions. Notice, of course, that C2H4 is an exception to that. Because most of our free energy of formation values are negative, it's very helpful to break this into smaller parts to avoid any sign errors. So my products add up to a negative 1245.9, and my reactants are, of course, just the 68.4. When we add all of this together, or subtract, we get a final value of negative 1314.3 and just kilojoules. Again, realize that our moles are canceling out in here. Again, we're back to addition and subtraction, so we're limited to the least number of decimal places. From C2H4, it only has one decimal place, so our final answer has one decimal place. Worked example 16.8 in our textbook. Would work through another example of this. And the last parting thought I want to leave you with is to recognize that what we've just done is calculate our standard free energy for the same reaction two different ways. Here, of course, we're using our products minus reactants with a value of negative 1314.3. And just a couple of slides ago, we calculated for the same reaction a negative 1314.2. So recognize that we calculated the same quantity. They're different in that last decimal place. That's due to rounding differences. We get the exact same quantity for delta G naught, no matter how I calculate it. And so one of the key things that I want you to recognize and understand is that delta G naught values for any given reaction are constant. Because it's measured at standard state conditions, there's only one possible value for it. Whereas delta G values can change because we can change concentrations and pressures and temperatures.